Hey guys, Aleph Zero here. Today I will be showing you guys how to create your own dynamic stamp on the latest version of Adobe Acrobat as of 2016. Now to clarify what dynamic means the stamp will be able to automatically update according to when you place the stamp down. The best examples are your name and the date on which the stamp is placed down. I will show you both of these things in addition to other things in this video. To start off, you must have downloaded Adobe Acrobat on your computer. This method of stamp creation works on other versions of Adobe Acrobat too, but the look of the program may be different. Next, you should have a file that contains the blank template of your stamp. I will be using this generic submittal stamp for today's tutorial video. First, open Adobe Acrobat. Now we go to Tools and click the Stamp selection. You can click Add Shortcut so that the stamps icon appears on the right, but you don't have to. Now click on the Stamps button. Hit the Create button and it will prompt you to select the file. Notice that the program may only allow you to select PDF files unless you change the selection down here. My stamp image is in a PNG, so I will change the criterion down below to PNG and select that file. A preview of your stamp will show up, so click OK. Next, you can categorize your new stamp by creating a new category or by selecting an old one. You can also name your new stamp. At this point, Adobe Acrobat has created a new file to store your stamp. We need to locate this file and edit it to make the stamp dynamic. So next, we will open the Tools menu and scroll all the way down to JavaScript. You don't really need to have experience with JavaScript to understand this video. All you need to do is click the drop-down menu and select Add Shortcut so that the JavaScript icon pops up on the right part of the Adobe Acrobat program. Click the JavaScript button and click the debugger tool that pops up at the top of the screen. Adobe Acrobat will ask you to enable the debugger tool, so make sure you select Yes. Once the debugger tool is open, type into the console this command, and then hit Control and Enter at the same time if you are on PC, or Command and Enter at the same time if you are on Mac. This code locates where Adobe Acrobat stores your custom-made stamp files. Make sure you copy the link that the console spits out, and we will move on from there. Now open Windows Explorer on your PC or Finder on Mac. On Windows Explorer, paste the link into the search bar at the top and make sure the syntax of the link is correct. On Mac, hit the buttons Shift-Command-G to activate the Go function. Paste your link here and make sure you delete the /Macintosh HD in the beginning. If you created only one custom stamp so far, open the one file that is in the folder you were sent to. Otherwise, you might have to track down exactly where your new stamp has gone. Note that if you created multiple custom stamps under the same category, they will all be stored in the same file. It's just how Adobe Acrobat works. Once you have your stamp file open, click the button Prepare Form on the right side of the screen and click OK when the screen prompts you to use your stamp file to create the form. Adobe Acrobat may have detected some of the errors where you would have wanted to add in text fields, but it may also miss some. So add in the text fields that you want filled in when the stamp is placed down, but don't actually fill those text fields in just yet. Take the time to rename your text fields if you want. Be careful that if you copy and paste a text field, you take the time to make sure the names of those identical text fields are different. Let's begin by editing the stamp so that the stamp displays the date on which it is first placed down. Double-click the text field where the date will be printed, and click the Calculate selection up top. Now select the radio button for a custom calculation script, and enter in this code. You can also edit the formatting between the quotation marks to something like mm/dd/yy if you prefer that format. Next, let's edit the text field that will receive your input for a name. Similar to what we did for the date text field, we will double-click the text field that corresponds to the name area and click the calculate selection up top. For the custom calculation script, we will enter all of this code. In short, this code activates a JavaScript window that will ask for user input only when two conditions are met simultaneously. The first one is that the stamp is placed down. But we have to add another condition, that the stamp placed down is this one unique stamp. Here you might notice that there is an empty spot between these quotations, and that's there for a reason. Make sure you enter in all the code and leave the empty spot there because we'll come back to it in just a moment. Adobe Acrobat categorizes each one of the stamps you make with a custom stamp ID that you can edit. To do that, we will go to Document Processing here on the right side. Now we will select Page Templates and click the Manage button. We notice here that there already exists a page template that corresponds to your already existing stamp. We will delete that for now and create a new one from scratch. During this process, you just need to keep in mind that whatever on the left side of the equation sign is now the stamp ID, and that whatever on the right side of the equation sign is the category that the stamp will be put into. Make sure that when you are making a new page template, that you are creating it specifically for the page on which your stamp lies on. In my case, my stamp is on page 2, so I need to make sure page 2 of 2 shows up on the left side of my screen. Now that we've created a custom stamp ID, double-click the name text field once again and enter in the custom stamp ID into the blank space. Make sure after you're all done that you save this file as a completely new file in the Adobe Acrobat stamp folder. Congratulations, you've successfully created your stamp. Now when you go back to try your stamp, you'll notice that you will have two copies of your stamp. One of which is the blank template without any code or text fields, and one that dynamically responds to your input. The latter stamp is the one we will keep, so delete the template. Thank you for watching this video, and please leave any suggestions for me in the comments down below. If you have any questions, feel free to leave them down below as well. Thanks again, and I hope this video helped.